Good afternoon from AC Electric Company. My name is Isaac Obel Jorgensen. I'm the Visalia Division Manager. Today I'm pleased to introduce to you our summer intern, Mauricio Gomez. Mauricio is one of seven students to be chosen from an applicant pool of nearly 300, and he's interning with us this summer. He's an electrical engineering student from Cal Poly San Luis Obispo and spent the last 10 weeks working with my operations management team here in Visalia. We've been pleased with his progress, and we're looking forward to his final presentation today. Please join me in welcoming Mauricio.
Thank you, Isaac, for the introduction. Hello, everyone. I'm Mauricio Gomez. I had the privilege to work here as an intern in Visalia Division. I am an electrical engineering student at Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, and this is my presentation. So part of my presentation was to talk about the company and analyze it in terms of its structure, its mission, and its values, and what I saw, especially relating to what I saw here in my cellular division. So starting off with structure, something that I saw here was strong leadership and this strong sense of community as well. I saw strong leadership in the way that the employees handled themselves, and on top of things they were, how hardworking and dedicated they were. And I feel that this speaks about strong leadership because it's the leadership that sets the standard of the employee behavior and overall productivity and motivates their people. I also saw community here as well. We have like these barbecues all the time, and everyone's really friendly. Every time I come in, Angela and Stacey are in the front welcoming with a warm smile. And I feel that's something that says a lot about the company. So I also looked at the company's mission in terms of quality and growth, something that are two aspects that I think go well hand in hand. So I got to see firsthand how the company handles quality. I went out to a couple of job sites and hung out with some of the workers out there, got to speak to them and see the kind of stuff that they're doing, kind of stuff that AC is doing. And I can honestly say that they're all doing good work, and our branches, such as construction, tech services, and AC Solar, their work speaks for themselves, as well as, it's also nationally recognized, like the AC Solar branch was just recently named number six solar contractor in the nation. And through all this quality work that AC has been doing, it of course has led to growth. We just opened, not too long ago, the Southern California Division, and in the near future we're going to be doing the Northern California Division. And so it really just says how the company sees this growth as important, and also seeing how important the growth of the employees is to the company, which I will talk about in the company's values. And two values I would like to highlight are safety and improvement. So about safety, the company has the safety bulletins and the safety butts. And I feel that the safety bulletins help emphasize how important safety is. We get these emails all the time, we read through them, and everybody signs off on them, making sure they understand what was read. And the safety bugs, I feel, is a good reward system in promoting how important safety is. Also, the safety advisory team, goes out and they do these safety checks to make sure the guys in the field have the correct equipment that they need. Fire extinguishers are up to date. I had the privilege to go out with Mark Patino on safety checks here in Visalia Division. And from him, what I saw was how serious and thorough these safety checks are. And it just said a lot about how important safety is. I also see how important improvement is for the company. If you go onto the AC portal, one of the things you'll see is a link on the first page. It's saying, if you have an idea that can help make a process faster, something that you do, or maybe if you just have a problem, AC wants to know about it, or they're saying that they want this from their employees, which tells us that they are open to hearing about these things and they want to make sure that everybody is working productively and that they're knowing what they're doing. I've also been part of two different morning meetings at different divisions. I went to the construction services and saw the morning meeting there, and here at Viselia Division, we base our morning meetings off of theirs. You know, we talk about some bugs that we have, how we can fix them, and how we're improving what we're doing. And this just overall helps us be more productive and shows how important improvement is for everybody. So a little bit about my internship experience and who I worked under. I liken these people to Star Wars characters, as some of the other interns have done when comparing who they've worked with, the characters. This would be Isaac, because something that I see in Isaac that sort of reflects Luke Skywalker is how Isaac, you know, started off as an apprentice and through years of hard work and dedication became the seasoned veteran who is now ready to share his knowledge, his wealth of knowledge, with the new younger generation, which would be Crystal. Here is Ray. And something that I see in Ray that resembles Crystal, or that Crystal resembles with Ray, is how Crystal is fearless, she's headstrong in her work, and she shows lots of promise in helping the company grow and achieve its goals. With Stacey and Angela, I see them as like C-3PO and R2-D2, the iconic duo. And this is just because, you know, they're very helpful and they got a wide variety of skills. And every time I have a question, I can go to them and they'll point me in the right direction. I'm not sure who would be who, you know, that's for them to debate. Something else about my internship, some of the things I did here. So I worked on invoices, you know, managing invoices, packing slips, making sure that, you know, help make sure that the bills are paid. I also learned about the OSHA safety guidelines. And then I also did create a wide variety of technical documents using Excel, PowerPoint, and Word. So some of the things I learned in my internship experience, one of the big things was safety at job sites and how to recognize hazards and how to prevent them. I also learned about how important LinkedIn is through training by Kelly Honore. And it's something that I definitely haven't utilized and will be doing so in the future. I also learned about lean culture and continuous improvement, about this idea of how through little incremental improvements in a process, it just saves you 2 seconds at a time, can add up and make this huge difference in the way we do things. I also learned about how to, you know, tow a trailer, which is may not seem like a big deal, but for someone that drives a little 89 Toyota, I wouldn't have had the chance to learn about this if it hadn't been for Mike Velasquez, who took me out to help him a couple of times with towing a trailer. Just general knowledge that will, you know, could potentially help me out in the future. So 5 takeaways. Ted Rose, Isaac Bell Jorgensen connected me with Ted Rose, an electrical engineer who has a company here in Visalia, and he works along with us in some projects. And what he was telling me about his experience in growing as a professional was how, you know, there was a couple moments in his life where he just started talking to, you know, random people that happened to be around him when, at the same place, same time, and through these people, just one conversation opened up a world of opportunities for him. And I can definitely say that I can at times be a little hesitant on talking to people that in both professional and personal relationships, for both parties to come out, you know, on the positive side, and is possible, but people just don't think about it. People may not want to go that extra mile to find that win-win solution, but it is something that we should definitely strive for. And a quote here from one of the guys out in the field, one of the foremen, Ryan Tobin. When I asked him what advice he had for me as an electrical engineering student who could be like prospectively looking into this industry in the future, he told me, don't be arrogant. And what he meant by this was that You know, sometimes some electrical engineers will go, won't even go out to these job sites. They just assume they know so much, and they fail to cooperate with the others that are around them. And this stuck out to me because I know that in any specialty or industry, there's going to be egos, and it's just easier to not cooperate with people than it is to go the extra mile and talk to people. And that's the kind of person I want to be. I want to be out there making sure that I'm doing this right and I'm making these connections with people, and in order to work more effectively and get the job done. So a few recommendations I have for the internship is maybe some more cooperation and collaboration between the talent and organizational development and some of the divisions that are hiring these interns, just to make like a sort of intern description, you know, what the jobs are going to be so that everybody's on the same page. I really enjoyed my talk with Ted Rose, so I think that future prospective interns would like exposure with professionals in their respective fields. So like myself, as an electrical engineer, you know, meeting electrical engineer Ted Rose, that was really cool. And something I also thought that future students might like is more intern collaboration. Maybe, you know, just get together on a certain day where they all get together and do this one project, or maybe just an entire 10-week internship where there's two students work together to make one project. So another part of this presentation was choosing a lean process topic. And my lean process topic was how I implemented lean around the office. And these are some tools that I used. Like here's a 2-second lean book by Paul Akers. In the book, he also talks about the 8 deadly sins of waste and about the 5 S's of lean and how they can be used to sort of eliminate some of these wastes or just save some time in a process so that you can be more productive and move on to more important things. So something that I did here, as I spoke about earlier, is invoices. So this is an example of what like the invoice approval system looks like. And one of the things that bugged me at the beginning when I was first doing this is that I was kind of overwhelmed by the amount of invoices that there were. So I would be committing one of the 8 deadly sins of waste, which was overprocessing. I was looking at these over and over again because I was forgetting which ones I had looked at. So I decided to create an Excel spreadsheet that very much resembled these identifiers of the invoices, but the key to me was this last date checked. So that would just tell me, you know, when was the last time I looked at this, so that I wouldn't have to be looking at the same invoice over and over again, like, oh yeah, I looked at this one and it's not there. And I just sort of used continuous improvement throughout this whole process to, you know, save more and more time and be more and more organized. And so I started off with, you know, just the last 8 checked, and then I realized, you know, maybe they're not missing. Maybe I just need a credit rebill or they need a signature. So I added the notes to help me out with that, so I wouldn't be looking for packing slips that I have already. And then I noticed that, you know, some of them are on the online folders, and those are the ones that have the Bakersfield address. So I added the Bakersfield column as well. And from there, like I was saying, it was just continuous improvement, you know, one of the huge concepts of lean. I went from, you know, having an invoice number column to an identifying number, because not all of the invoice numbers are consistent with the packing slip numbers. Like for Gray Bar and South Valley, they use different numbers. My missing packing list Excel spreadsheet of having to fill out that other column. It's just one less column I have to worry about. And furthermore, it just got to the point where there was just so much invoices that Isaac suggested, if they're over a week old, you know, like, let's send them to the PMs and make sure that this material was received. So, you know, when I had originally created this, it was for the last 8 checked column, but it ended up just going into the days old column, and I realized through this process of continuous improvement how easy it is to just move from like what Something else that I did here was, you know, just practicing strengthening, using two S's of lean, strengthen and sustain. So this is one of our supply cabinets. It was actually really accessible in terms of how easy it was to get things. It just was a little unorganized. And this reminded me a lot about the Hawks company, which was like an electrical circuit design company out in Japan that Paul Akers talked about in his book, and how they used streaming and sustaining in order to make their company more productive because people were wasting less time having to look for things. So what they did was that they organized everything and they put labels on all their equipment, which was what I did here. So you can see the before and after picture. And the labels that I put there just to make it easier to see where to get things. And when someone's done using the supply, they can put it back and just keeps it in the same place, helps sustain that location. You know, people remember where they got it from the next time. And it's also very aesthetically pleasing. I also looked at another one of the supply cabinets for the printer ink of the division. We have four different printers here. So I made this Excel spreadsheet here to help Stacy and Angela whenever they're ordering new ink. They just look up the product number on this sheet, and they don't have to waste the time of having to guess what it is or having to look around the box. And I also put this notes section down here so that if somebody needs the ink, they can just see, okay, well, you know, if I'm using the reception area printer and I need to put new ink, like, what do I need? Oh, well, it's the LaserJet 507A ink. So just want something more to save time. And then one of the things that Isaac had noticed was that we were spending a lot on our coffee service. So our original provider was Coffee Break Service, and I was tasked with looking. Was at Costco. So I looked at, you know, the brand, just replacements of all these things would be here as well. And as you can see, the coffee that we were buying was $400 cheaper if we were to go through Costco, as well as, you know, the hot cocoa, that's also cheaper. The creamers were cheaper. Everything was cheaper. But still, you can see that the Starbucks coffee would cost like $1,000 a year, you know, to get the same amount as we had gotten the year before. And so I thought of different alternatives. You know, well, we're already using sugar and creamer to flavor this coffee. I suggested that we move away from the coffee service, that we get our own coffee maker and carafe, and all of that, you know, would be an expense. Overall, it's still a good investment because of the huge difference in between what we were spending and what we would be spending. And I talked to Isaac and the team here about it, and they agreed. And so now we broke away from the coffee service. We have our own coffee maker and our own carafe, and we're implementing this the Costco alternative. So is there any questions? Kind of hit the button a little quick there at the end. That's it.
Nicely done.
Thank you. And so there's a lot of traffic in the direction I used to come before, and looked at, you know, alternatives as to how I can save some time there. As well as, you know, just getting up every morning, getting here on time. You know, how can I arrange things, or how can I do things in the morning so I'm not walking back and forth in between my room, the restroom, the kitchen, and wasting time there. And so those are just two simple examples of how I've this sort of like lean process has stuck with me.
Would you recommend AC Electric to other students as an internship, and why?
Yes, I would recommend AC Electric to other students because this is just an opportunity to get into an industry that maybe students may overlook. They just think that it's just Well, you know, I know, of course, for me, I just thought it was like something, oh, they're just people out there just doing some construction and road work. But it's a lot more than that. You know, everybody here is really helpful. They got lots of wisdom. I know in this room alone, there's over like 40, 50 years of experience of this industry. And so there's just a wealth of knowledge to be absorbed, especially as, you know, as people, as a student that just sits in the library most of the day, just studying and reading books, you're not going to get exposed to this stuff out in the library or in a study room.
What was your favorite part about the internship?
My favorite part of the internship was going out and seeing, like, just job sites, going to places I wouldn't normally have access to as just a normal civilian, like going to Ventura Coastal with Chris, or going over to the medical center with you, Aaron?
Yeah.
Out in Porterville, the mental health center. Just going out and talking to the guys and picking their brain. So yeah, like I said, it was something that I wouldn't be exposed to if I was just at school.
Have you shared any of your lean process, like for the invoices, with Angela so she can take it and try and develop some of those techniques yourself? Have you showed her that?
I have not showed her that, but I can show her that.
Good, we still got 2 hours.
Get to work.
Cool.
When do you start school?
I start school September 14th. Me, Benjamin, and Steve. We'll be out there on Thursday. A couple weeks, 2 weeks? 3 weeks? I still got time.
Very good. So, go ahead.
Yeah, sorry. I kind of jumped the button at the, hit the button a little quick there at the end, but with my concluding thoughts, I wanted to start off by just thanking everybody that has taken the time to, you know, just talk to me, answer questions, you know, give me some patience with all my questions. And especially everybody here in the Mycelia division, Isaac, Crystal, Aaron, Chris, Angela, Stacy, Albert, Mike, Josh, all the guys in the field, Mark Bettino, Ted Rose. I really value everything that I've been able to absorb and soak up in a seemingly short amount of time.
Thank you, Mauricio.
Nice job.
Nicely done. Thank you to everybody for joining us on Facebook Live. And don't forget to like our Facebook page before you leave. There's another presentation coming up at 2:45. See you later.